So I'm guessing all of you must have heard about passive investing. You might have actually read some articles in the newspapers also where experts would be saying that passive investing is a much better style of investing compared to active. And let me tell you, all of them are very true. Passive is a lot better and much more relaxed way of investing versus active style of investing. If you want to understand what exactly we mean by passive and active investing and how they are broadly different from each other, I would request you to actually see our previous video where we covered the topic in full detail. But in this video, we would be talking about the three major benefits of passive investing. So let's start with the first benefit. So the biggest advantage of passive investing is that it's the most peaceful way of investing. Okay. Let's try to understand this with an example. Suppose you want to invest into dividend paying stocks, okay, and you're investing for your retirement and your investment horizon might be 20 years or 30 years. Okay. So let's say you build a portfolio of 15 to 20 stocks today and you decide to look at your portfolio only once a year to see that if anything needs to be done in the portfolio. So that's one style of executing, which is the passive way of executing the portfolio. Okay. The other way could be that today you start with a portfolio of 15 to 20 stocks, okay, but you're constantly reading the newspapers and seeing the stock price movement and decide to churn the portfolios depending upon the new information that is coming into the market. That, okay, something might happen wrong with this company, so let me drop this company from my portfolio and include some other company. Okay. So in this example, the first way of executing things is actually very peaceful, and the second way of executing things is more opportunistic in nature and might work out for you, might not work out for you. Okay. So when we say that the biggest advantage of passive investing is that it is the most peaceful way of investing, we say that because we know that in long term, equity markets will work for you. Okay. Everything, like if you take a period of 10 to 15 years and take any cross section of the market, okay, you will see that it has always worked in your favor. But if you take, let's say, a cross section of 1 week, 1 month, or 1 day for that matter, nobody can predict what's going to happen in the stock market, right? So passive is much better, it is more relaxed, and if you're investing for your retirement, how does it matter what's happening today in the stock market, right? Whether the stock market is going down or whether it is going up. Okay, so it's advisable not to be opportunistic in the stock market, not to bet on different things that comes on your way. Pick a particular strategy and execute in a very passive manner, because at the end of it, you are investing for either your retirement or some other financial goal that you might have. Okay. And that's actually the second advantage of passive investing, that it works very well when you want to invest for goals. So the second advantage of passive investing is that it helps you achieve your goals. Okay. You can align your goals with your investments. If you talk to any expert, any financial expert, they would always say that if you are a retail investor, it's better always to identify what are your goals in life. And when I say goals, I'm talking about long-term goals. You might have a goal to do something tomorrow, but stock market is not for that. Okay. If a financial expert if you go to a financial expert and it says that you should first identify your long-term goals and then align your investments according to those goals, then that can be very easily done using passive investing. The goals could be different. It might be your retirement, it might be the marriage of your children, it might be about buying a home in long term, right? So there can be different goals for different people, and if the idea is to achieve these goals in 5, 10 or 15 years, right? So how does it matter what's happening today in the market, right? So passive lets you do things very peacefully, and at the same time it helps you align your investments with your long term goals. So the last but very important benefit of passive investing is that it is very low cost in nature. Now, if you look at the same example where we made a portfolio of 15 to 20 stocks and we decided to just look at the portfolio once every year, okay. So it might happen that at the end of the year when you are reviewing your portfolio, you might end up making some change, okay. But In the same case, when we are executing the strategy actively, okay, it might happen that on a monthly basis, you might buy certain stocks, might sell certain stocks. So there is more churn happening in your portfolio, okay? And when there is more churn, there is more cost. Because when you buy or sell securities in a stock market, and by securities I mean stocks and ETFs, right, there are costs associated with it. You might have to pay brokerage, you might have to pay some transaction fee to the exchanges or SEBI, right? So there are different costs and taxes associated with transactions in a stock market. And the lesser the churn in your portfolio, the lesser is the cost. And the lesser the cost, the more are the returns, okay? Now, we in the coming videos, we would be talking about ETFs and mutual funds. But just to give more color to the argument of low cost investing, right? There are different types of mutual funds. Okay, there are actively managed mutual funds. There are passively managed mutual funds. Okay. In case of actively managed mutual funds, the expense ratios are much higher. It might be around 2%. In case of passively managed mutual funds, the expense ratios are much lower. It might be around 1% or even lower also for that matter, right? And if you are investing in a mutual fund, let's say for 1 year, and the return generated is 10%, okay? So in case of an actively managed mutual fund, if the expense ratio is 2%, at the end of 1 year, your returns will be just 8%. In case of passively managed fund, if the returns were the same, that is 10%, you might end up with 9 or 9.5% for that matter. Okay. And in case of instruments like small cases, there is no expense ratio at all. You only pay when you transact, right? So as you can see, the lower the cost, the higher is the return. And in long term, it becomes very important because these small differences in expense ratio or the management fee, when accumulated over long term of let's say 10 to 15 years, results into huge cost for the investors, right? So we looked at the three major benefits of passive investing. That is, it is the most peaceful way of investing. The second is that it helps you align your investment with your goals. And the third and very important one, that it is very low cost manner of executing investment strategy, right? In the next video, we would be talking about the different options or instruments available in India, which lets you take passive exposure in the stock market.